Welcome back, everyone. Toy Shiz here, and I am back yet again for yet another Hasbro Marvel Legends video. It has been a while since we've done one of these, but it's also been a while since we've had a cool wave with not only just seven figures, but then also a Build-A-Figure. They become few and far between, but hopefully it's for the better, because right off the bat, we have some new boxes. This is part of the Hasbro initiative to make everything look the same in their lines, which... I open the boxes and I throw them away anyways, but I guess it's good for some collectors. It's got great artwork, and I like that it says Strange Tales on the top. Now, the first figure today will be Mutant X Bloodstorm, which is Storm, an alternate reality Storm, who was bitten by Dracula and basically has the same powers as you would know, flying, electricity, controlling the weather. You get the idea. You got seven figures in this wave. We got Blackheart as the Build-A-Figure and the Weapon of Vengeance. The Helverine does not have a part. But again, like I said, the boxes are pretty cool if you're one of those that want to keep it inside said packaging. Although I don't know why you would in this day and age, because they're a lot of fun to take out and play with. And here's the barcode, but you're not going to need this. They are largely available online. Mine came from Entertainment Earth, and I will put links down in the description below. Next up is Brother Voodoo. Certainly not the first foray of Brother Voodoo into the Marvel Legends line. And to be honest with you, I really wish they would have tackled his first appearance look. That would have been a welcome addition, especially to this wave. We have Damien Hellstrom. Not exactly the costume, quote-unquote, that I would have preferred for this character, but you can read up on him if you'd like. We also have Dracula, not just any Dracula, but Marvel's Dracula, which looks a little untold if you ask me, but yes, Vlad the Vampire is here and ready to rumble. We also have Lilith, who makes her debut in Marvel Legends, which, hey, it's always great to have a new character. She's the mother of demons, Ghost Rider baddie, and we'll talk more about her as we get into the video. We also have Moon Knight, much like Brother Voodoo. It's kind of Moon Knight overload. This costume is a little bit different than what we've gotten before, but again, it's another Moon Knight. And then we have the Weapon of Vengeance, of which, yes, you can just call him Helverine. You guessed it, Wolverine gets the Spirit of Vengeance. So there you go. And it's as dumb as all can be. But more on that in just a few, because this is gonna be an absolute blast. Sit back, relax, grab yourself a nice hot spooky cup of coffee. This look at the latest Hasbro Marvel Legends Build-A-Figure wave, featuring all the spooky Halloween characters just in time for October. Here we go. And while I got you Halloweenies here, I just want to say thanks so much for always checking out my YouTube vids, and if you haven't already, please do consider subscribing. Why? Well, we have old toys, we got new toys, daily news updates. Guarantee you'll find something here that you like. So, to kick off everything, we have Moon Knight. Good old Mark Spector. Man, that Disney Plus TV show was a drag, but he comes with his Ankh weapon accessory. Evil warder offer thingy. Looks pretty good. It's all gold. Then you got a couple extra fists in case you want to pummel your enemies. You get a variety of moonerangs. We've seen this before. Don't lose them. This is why I kept them in the tape, just to show you easy peasy. In terms of the Moon Knight himself, it's gonna be a Moon Knight figure. It's nothing to write home about. It's got all that Marvel Legends articulation. He's got a sweet cape, white on the back, dark on the inside, and for what paint there is, it's decently done. He's got his staff, his moon symbol, you got gold bracelets and ankle boots and all that kind of stuff. He's fine for what it is. He is just okay. Next up, for all you Toy Biz fans out there who remember Mutant X, we have Bloodstorm. She comes with some swappable hands, more vampire claw hands, and then outstretched weather controlling hands. But I like that she comes with a fangs out alternate head portrait. She kind of has a little faux hawk into a rat's tail kind of thing going on. Pretty cool. Well painted, I will say. I like the blood red eyes with the black around it. And it does pop onto the neck easy peasy, and it looks pretty cool. Overall, I do like this Bloodstorm figure. But I really wish that she would have come with some, I don't know, storm powers, mutant powers, something like that, because... well, she's got to be directing something with those hands out. And don't get me wrong, I like the figure itself. She's got some great paint to her, nice details, the boots, the pants, everything looks good. She's even got the little X-Men belt. But without the powers, while she is a cool-looking figure, ultimately, she is very humdrum. And that kind of coincides with this guy right here, Damien Hellstrom, of which if you saw that show or you tried to make it through all those episodes, of which, yeah, good luck. There are a couple extra fists and hands. Nice. They got the big seams down the middle. That doesn't look too good. He does come with his trident accessory weapon. It's just a solid gold plastic. Looks good. Looks like what's in the comics. There's not much to it. This shirtless dude, though, again, not exactly the Damien Hellstrom I would have preferred. Maybe a red-caped Hellstrom. He's barefoot. He's got that symbol on his chest, which is nicely applied. But again, he's just, you know what I mean? It's got a great head portrait to him. He's got that going for him. But a very detailed head portrait, and then not really anything else on the body. He's got a giant hole on his back. It, again, is just kind of like, I know this is a version from recent comics, but yeah, you know what I mean? And next up we have Brother Voodoo, again, a character we have seen many times in Marvel Legends. He comes with his staff, of which we have seen before as well. Translucent purple, has some demons sculpted on there. Little brown paint for the handle of the staff, kind of looks like it's morphing into that ethereal look. Also some spooky ethereal purple powers, of which I think would have been better suited for a character like Lilith, if we're being honest. And you get a couple extra hands, nothing to write home about. Fisted hands, open hands. Brother Voodoo himself, probably the best released version thus far. If you don't have a Brother Voodoo in your collection, well, look no further, because he's pretty cool. He's got lots of paint, the face is cool, he's got the V on the forehead. He's got the Doctor Strange cape, it's solid red with a little bit of yellow for the amulet in the front. Little dangly bits, skulls on his belt. The white could have definitely been painted better, especially in the creases of the sculpts. Overall, it's a pretty solid Brother Voodoo. And like I said, if you've never had a Brother Voodoo in your Marvel Legends collection, well, look no further. He comes with all the accessories you would ever need for a character like this. But for me personally, I just look at it and go, yep, that's another Brother Voodoo in the old collection. Which brings us to Lilith. Hey, that's a new character. Always great to have new characters in the Marvel Legends line. She comes with a pair of fists. And that's it. No spooky Halloween powers, no conjuring, no demon minions, nothing. It's just her. And she does have a decent head sculpt to her. It's a reused body, but unfortunately she suffers from some really bad paint applications. Her hair is cool if you get it up to the light. It's kind of a translucent, spooky, smoky effect. Her cape, I guess you would call it that, on the back is removable. It simply just pegs into her back. So at least she has that going on, if you want to call that an accessory. She's got some purple makeup, she's got some green earrings, but like I said, the paint itself for the fishnet look, it's just really not applied well at all. In fact, mine has some thumb smudges to it where it just doesn't line up correctly. And if I'm being honest, the extra hands is such a humdrum accessory, quote unquote. Nothing to really drive home the powerful mother of demons and take on Ghost Rider. She's ultimately, nah. And then you have Dracula, which, I'll be honest with you, Dracula is definitely a favorite from this wave. Even though it's not exactly the look I would think of for Marvel's Dracula, but yes, it is very accurate. He comes with extra armored hands. He even has a more solemn, I'm maybe thinking about drinking your blood, sort of head portrait. He's got some gold dangly bit earrings. The hair is pretty cool, although on mine, let me just point this out. I thought that I had flecks of paint that I could scratch off. Don't do that because it took more of the paint off. It's actually the paint underneath that's seeping through because of the sculpted bits. Be careful. Also, if you were wondering, yes, he does have some ponytail articulation, which, oddly enough and funnily enough, yes, you can get him into some windswept looks for Dracula. And the teeth out head portrait is awesome. That is very cool. I love that. Very evil, very spooky. Very much a head portrait I would want for Dracula. The cape is awesome. It looks like bat wings, like draped down. That's really cool. It's a nice little visual touch. The armor, the different blood red pieces, the paint is awesome. Amidst the black and the cape, they really did a great job. And yes, it's all new sculpt. He has a really cool Dracula sword to him, of which, yes, he has the hands to hold it well. The cape will kind of hinder the arms, to be honest with you, but I love the single jointed elbows they got going on because of just the way it folds in. It looks like you're articulating cloth, but it's plastic, and they did a great job there. He's all pinless. He's got appropriate hands. He's got great articulation. It's all the Marvel Legend articulation you would expect. The hair, again, articulates, getting him into that I'm doing battle with Blade look. It's awesome. They did a great job on this figure, and I'm really stoked. I think you can hear it in my voice. The knees can get kind of clunky with the double joints and the armor, of course. It kind of looks like a loyal subject sort of dealio. And then you got plenty of feet articulation, pegs. The pointy bits are sharp, so be careful. More on that with Blackheart. But yeah, overall, this is a solid Dracula. And then we have this thing. Which, comics, you know? Okay, I'm gonna be honest with you. This is pretty sweet. As much as I think this is the dumbest thing in the world, it's actually pretty cool. I'm not gonna be too hard on this. You have an adamantium skull with fire spilling out of it, of which the fire looks like Wolverine's hair. It is so stupid, but stupidly amazing. I like the adamantium skeleton. You got the whites of the teeth, except when you put the head back all the way, it's gonna pop right off. Same exact articulation. You got a bit of a brown costume Wolverine, different belts. All the articulation that you would like. And the best part, of course, being that you can go snicked and his adamantium fire claws pop out. And I like this. This, again, it's so, so dumb. But it works oh so well. It must be the Halloween season, which has just given me all the kinds of, yeah, this is pretty cool. I dig it. It's just Wolverine with fire spilling out of him. And as dumb as this is, it totally works. Whether it be Logan or I think it's Dakin too, kind of goes back and forth. I don't need to know any more about this character. It's Wolverine and he is Ghost Rider. But what is cool is the Build-A-Figure. Finally, Blackheart makes his return to Marvel Legends. We have not seen him since the Toy Biz days. More on that in just a few. But I do like that they gave you some optional hands. So you got a fisted hand and a finger pointing, I'm going to take you to hell kind of hand. The sculpt on it is pretty cool. Kind of reminds me of Venom in a way, but he's a lot more prickly, this Blackheart. And the head portrait with the dreads is very well done. He has a really long tail. It has a bendy wire, kinda sorta at the tip. Now, it's gonna kinda work with you, mostly to kinda stabilize him, but you kinda have to work at it. He has those feet, which look pretty cool. Overall, the figure looks great. Let's just be honest there. But the articulation, you can't really get his arms going all the way down. Like I said, when you put in all the pieces, be careful of basically the needles that are all over him. He's a very prickly character. It even goes on to the tail, of which, yes, it's all well and good. It looks great. Little bit of a purple shading to the hair. The eyes really stand out in that kind of blank, demon-y face. But yeah, the hair, I really wish they would have pushed the purple a little bit more, even to extend the purple to most of the body. It kind of picks it up on camera. It's a little bit brighter. A little bit brighter in person. But yeah, really drive home that purplish kind of demonic nature for him. I think that would have been kind of cool. Like the eyes. The eyes really stand out. He does have some great articulation to him, but some of it, like I said, in the arms is in a way sort of limiting. When you have the legs and the double joint and the way his feet are, that is really where the tail is going to come in handy to keep him steady. So in a lot of ways, and all the time that's passed since the original Toy Biz figure, it's basically the same one and the same standing issues. When you look at the original Toy Biz one, yeah, I would say it's a definite upgrade, although I still like the Toy Biz one, even though now looking at it, it looks like a cat that just woke up and cleaned its hair wrong. It's still cool, but yes, this one for a modern Marvel Legends collection, it's a lot more, we'll say, on model, but there is definite things I like about the old one, minus the ball joints and some of the articulation. It's just the nostalgic factor for me. Toy Biz days, as opposed to now what Hasbro does with Marvel Legends. So that is why I like them. But yes, let's be honest, the brand new Build-A-Figure is definitely a whole heck of a lot better. When you look at villains for Ghost Rider, I know a lot of you are going to say, what about this one? What about this one? Just take it all in. Just enjoy that we have a semblance of a villain's rogue gallery for the characters that are all Ghost Rider. I think that that's pretty solid. But yes, we can always add more, that's for sure. And looking at this new Blackheart with the Danny Ketch Ghost Rider and Lilith, that's a 90s palooza right there. That is pretty darn cool. So yes, all of these go together. All of them look great. Bring on more Ghost Rider. And what I like to see is that this Dracula now mixed with the more recent Marvel Legends Blade, that's a nice pairing. And when you put this Dracula with Bloodstorm, that's pretty cool too. It's kind of an alternate reality where she pickpocketed Dracula and got bit as opposed to Professor X. Then you can put Bloodstorm with the Goblin Queen. You could also put her with Cyclops, even though, like I said, it's an alternate Earth sort of deal, but she eventually comes to 616. But hey, that's comics for you. And I certainly wouldn't mind more Mutant X characters, like The Fallen or Havoc, or heck, even more of a comic booky Goblin Queen. And believe it or not, this is not the first time we've seen some Hot Popped Claws Wolverine. Someone over at the Marvel Legends must have a little fetish for some fiery adamantium action, but yeah. Regardless of how Wolverine is portrayed, it's goofy, but it is fun. And then finally, what this wave really achieves is that you add some more spooky characters to your Marvel Legends collection. And like I said, Ghost Rider, the whole other side, magical side of the Marvel Universe, keep going, Marvel Legends. Let's see a whole heck of a lot more. So that's gonna wrap it up for my spooky look at the brand new Hasbro Marvel Legends Blackheart Build-A-Figure wave. Overall, I would say, based on my preferences and seeing a lot of new characters, that this is a solid wave, but I think more casual fans, it's gonna go over their heads. I've seen the comments, a lot of people saying, who is that? Who is that? Now, I'm more on the side of, we could have gotten some different costumes for these characters, more welcomed costumes, maybe some powers, a lot more powers for a few of these figures. But with any Marvel Legends wave, you have to throw in a few, oh yeah, I know who that is, and kind of leave the rest to be, yeah, if you want them, get them. If you want to build the figure, you can definitely do that. And while Dracula and Helverine are definitely my faves of the wave, Blackheart is definitely a solid Build-A-Figure. So, you've heard my thoughts. Now I'm curious to know yours. Comment below, let me know. Let's talk everything Marvel Legends. And I'm gonna leave you guys with that. As always, drink some great coffee, eat some great food, but most importantly, remember, I'm liking this just a few Build-A-Figure waves a year. More emphasis on quality over quantity. And when they do, let me know what you found. I'll talk to you guys soon. Adios.